I haven't done one in a very, very long time. I did used to do them quite a long while ago, but I stopped because I don't really buy that many products each month to warrant doing a favourites video. You would literally see the same thing each time. So as I've been loving quite a few things recently, I thought I would do a favourites video and show you guys some things that I have been loving. So I think first off, I'm going to start off with like some skincare and body care kind of things. And the first thing I have to show you guys is my Boots number 7 Radiance Boosting Hot Cloth Cleanser, and that just looks like that. I've actually done a full review of this on my beauty blog, so if you want to know like my precise thoughts on it, then I'll leave the link below. You guys can go on ahead and read that. But I've been using this for, I think, since around probably around from June of last year, I think. So this is my second bottle of tube, not bottle, and I bought this recently. I actually bought it at full price because I went into Boots and they were literally finishing that £5 offer, so I must really love this if I'm paying full price or something. But with the number 7 vouchers, you get it for £5 off, and this retails at £10, so it would have been £5, but twice I bought it full price. But I really love this cleanser. I think I'll do a skincare routine video soon, so if you guys would like a video on my skincare, just let me know, with thumbs up or whatever, let me know and I'll do one. But this, I just can't live without this right now. If my skin's being a bit funny or a bit irritated, I'll just cleanse with this using the, I use the muslin cloths it comes with. I just use that on my face and I swear it just calms my skin down. The next day it's just fine. So I can't go without using this, and if I'm being lazy then I pay for it, so I can't go without this. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to show you is kind of a 2-in-1 kind of sort of. This is the hemp foot protector. Again, I have recently done a blog post on this, and I will leave that link below. But I've been using this for like the past 2 or 3 weeks now, I think, and I've used quite a fair bit. But I got this half price, so I didn't pay full price for it, because the Body Shop were doing like a half price offer, and I think I got it for like £4.50. So it's a bit steep, but was it £4.50 or £5? I can't remember. But it's really, really moisturising. So I will use my normal body moisturiser, and then I'll use this separately just for my feet. And my feet are so soft after I use this. I love it, and I will definitely be repurchasing this once this is finished, because And then the next one is one that kind of goes hand in hand with this product, and it's the hemp hand protector. And this is like my third tube of this. I love this hand cream. And if you got there, it's a hand cream. But I love this so much. It gets your hands so, so moisturized. This winter, I didn't purchase it for some lazy reason. Well, yeah, I was lazy. And my hands suffered so much. The skin around my nails was just peeling. I've just got quite dry skin on my body. So I really need to make sure that I'm using products that are moisturizing my skin. And this works like a charm. Like, the skin around my nails is pretty much repaired now. It's not dry and peeling anymore. So I really need this all the time in my bag. I have to have this. I even got a backup. I bought 2 when I ordered it online because I love this. Okay, so much. Keeping on with the theme of like body care things, this is my Nivea SOS Lip Relief Balm thingamabobby. And I picked this up because I went into Boots and they ran out of my usual one, which is the Nivea SOS. It's got SPF, it's SPF 15, and so I just got this one instead, and I was like, oh, you know, it's got menthol, and I don't like menthol, I don't like that kind of tingly sensation, because as you can see, I don't need any sort of plumping going on, but I really like this, and I will be repurchasing it. It doesn't give me really big plump lips, but if you have, like, I'm just dry, as I said, and my lips sometimes go through this stage where just nothing gets them moisturised nothing except this and, well, the Nivea lip thingies in general, not the ones that come in the little tubey ones, but like these ones in this kind of packaging. They really, really moisturize my lips, and it's a must for before any sort of lipstick, because you can still moisturize, but then you're left with like lips just, they don't look smooth. So this really helps to smooth out my lips and just have them look a bit plump. So, but not big and full, like, okay, am I making sense? I don't know. But this works like a dream. So the next product, if you've watched my tutorials at all, is one that features quite heavily and quite often, and it's my MAC MSF Natural in Dark. Yep. And this is just such a great multi-purpose product. I use it to blend out eyeshadow that I've taken too far up, because it pretty much matches my skin. So I use it for that. I use it to set my under eye concealer. I use it to, if I've spot concealed, I'll just powder my face with this. And also if I've used any sort of liquid product on my face, I use this to set everything, and it just works like a dream. It doesn't give you like a huge amount of coverage or anything, it's just subtle. So I really love this product, and it's a big, big love of mine. I don't know if there's anything that would kind of take its place, so I'm so content with this product. So yeah. All right, so the next things I have, my current favorite highlighter, which is Sleek's Rose Gold. And you can see the color, it's kind of a rose gold, but the rose does not show up on my skin. Once it's blended out, all I really get is the gold, which I'm really fine with, because as you can probably tell, I like looking highlighted and I like it to be kind of obvious, and this really does that for me. It just gives you that really lovely golden glow, and as the day wears on and I get slightly, I don't get really, really oily, but I do get, you know, just a bit here and there, but as the day goes on and that happens, it just kind of gives my skin a glow. I don't know, I can't explain it, but I just love the look it gives me. So I've been reaching for this over my NARS Albatross, which is quite surprising because I love my Albatross, but this is definitely a favorite of mine. So the next products that I have are more cheap products, and I put them in my Z palette that I recently purchased and love. I got the pro size, mainly so that everything can like go in a straight line. I'm so OCD with things like this, but yeah. So I got this, and did I even mention what I was talking about? My Le Femme blushes, that's what I'm loving. So I've been really reaching for these ones and loving them. They're so pigmented, I can't even explain. You dip your brush in, and I need to shake my brush off, because if I put it straight in and then straight on my face, I'm gonna look crazy. And I've been using, the one I've been using in particular is Cinnabar, that one right there, and it's just a perfect neutral blush to use every day. I just can't fault it, really. Okay, so for the next two makeup products, I have my Sephora lipsticks, and I have here, do you know what, they have names on them, so I will have the names in the bottom, and they're two completely different finishes, as you can see. So you have the more matte packaging and the more glossy packaging. So this one is, I think off the top of my head, it might be Jealousy, but I'm not too sure. It looks like I have it on, but I don't have it on. I've been using this one every day, and it's a, you think it's going to be a nude, it is a nude, it's like a pinky nude, and it's just the perfect nude. I'm so excited I didn't get a backup of this. I got a backup of another one, but not this one. So I'm hoping to be maybe go to Paris to visit by the end of the year, so I will be stocking up on Sephora stuff. The next one is one that I actually wear on top of it, and again, I don't have the name, and it's like melted at times. It's a it's like a purpley pink color, and the finish of these kind of lipsticks from Sephora, they're akin to the MAC Luster finishes, but these are a lot glossier. So I use these together, and because I'm not a big fan of lip gloss, I have a few, like this is why you see the same glosses in all of my videos, because I don't really, I'm not a big fan of gloss, but this just provides me with the perfect amount of glossiness. It's not like, ooh, shiny, shiny. It's just a little sheen on your lips. So these two have been a really big love of mine and a big combination. Not a big combination, what am I saying? But a combination that I've been loving recently. Right, so I have a brush to show you, and it's my crown brush. It's the C433 Pro Blending Fluff Brush. Quite a name, and that's what it looks like. It's dirty because I used it today, as you can see. Choo, choo, choo. And I use it to, what I use it for is just kind of putting colour in the corner of my eye, and then using the tip of it and just blending in like this, and it just works like, oh, love it. It just kind of blends everything out really, really well. And if I want a more blended look, I'll just turn it on its side and then blend it into my non-existent crease. Well, I say I have one, but it's kind of a pathetic excuse for a crease. And because of the shape, it kind of just sits on your lid and blends everything out really, really well. I don't know if I'm explaining that really, I don't know if I'm explaining it properly, but yeah, I've been really liking this one. People say it's like a dupe to the MAC, to something, something, I don't know. But I think I might get the MAC one to see how it fares. I want to get the Sigma one, but I do not want to order Sigma unless I'm going to put in like a big order, and I need to save up for those brushes. I'm not ordering and paying shipping for one brush. So I think I'm just going to get the MAC one, so I just have one there and then rather than having to wait. So yeah, I've been really liking this one, and I'm going to be on the lookout for any sort of droopy ones. Yeah. Okay, now I have a random favourite to show you, and I wasn't going to put it in, but I've been loving it so, so much. And a few of you were asking me questions in the What's In My Bag video about the books I read, and I should hopefully be doing, sorry, I'm supposed to say that. I should hopefully be doing like a more book related videos on my vlog channel. I'm thinking of doing like maybe book recommendations, someone said they would like to see, so I might do something like that. But until then, I'm going to show you my random favourites, and I'm just going to show you my Kindle because I don't have the book version. And I'm currently reading Elizabeth Gaskell's, Elizabeth Gaskell? I think that's her name. I'll leave it, you know, somewhere below or in the video. It's her book North and South, and it's kind of written, I really love classics, so books that were written in kind of like Jane Austen time and 200 years ago or whatever. I really like those kinds of books. Don't ask me why, but I do. And this kind of, you know, you have your male and your female protagonist, and if think of kind of like Pride and Prejudice, it's kind of like that. The two people don't like each other, and then through things happening, they kind of begin to like each other. Cut out, and so yeah, it's a bit darker. However, it is nearly 6 o'clock, and I'm still able to film. Winning. So anyway, what was I saying? Yeah, I really like stories where the two main protagonists don't really like each other, and then through situations and stuff happening, they kind of learn to get over their prejudices and stuff like that. So so as I was saying, I was kind of comparing it to Pride and Prejudice, wherein that the two main characters came from such, I think the differences that they had were so great that they were prejudiced to each other. Or anyway, I'm not really explaining it very well. I'm not really explaining much very well today. But with North and South, it incorporates the differences, the cultural differences within the North of England and the South of England. Because I know like in the States, you guys have North and South, that kind of divide as well. So the South is seen as kind of like the hoity-toity, kind of bougie, more bougie. And then the North is of England is seen as kind of like more country and working class. That's kind of the image that history has, yeah, that's how it's been throughout history because of the Industrial Revolution, blah blah. Anyway, I'm just getting into stuff I shouldn't really be getting into. But yeah, if you like Pride and Prejudice, you'll probably like this one, and I really love this one. I've even stopped reading the book I was currently reading, which was Game of Thrones, because I just really, really wanted to reread this one. I read this book when I was like 16 or 17, and after seeing the BBC adaptation of it, I was like, I gotta see this, I gotta read this book. And I read the book and I really loved it. So yeah, it's a book recommendation for you guys. I'm sorry I blabbered on for a bit, but if you guys can't tell, I like to talk. So yeah, if you guys enjoyed that, let me know. I might do more favourites videos. They won't be every month because, as I said, I don't really buy that many products each month to warrant me doing a favourites video each month. But, you know, if I know you guys like them, I might try and make a conscious effort to do one here and there. So yeah, those are my favourites, and yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Bye!